Arizona. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the Green Bay Packers and the Arizona Cardinals. This fielded at the 2. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20. Call it the 21-yard line. They come out with one back and three tight ends. And Gresham's got it over the middle. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Let's look at this offense now, and let's talk about John Brown.
An exciting young talent from Pittsburgh State, home of the Gorillas. Hard to cover, great moves in short areas.
They'll run for the first time with Johnson. 2 yards the gain there, and now they're left with a third and about 4 for a first. And a peek at the defense for the Packers.
Haha, Clinton Dix attracted a lot of attention when he was about to enter the NFL for his ability to play the football in the air. He's actually shown that he can tackle pretty well in the league, too.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. J.J. Nelson, the intended target, and it brings up fourth down.
Third down is a down. Both sides know they absolutely have to win. And the name of the game for the defense is pressure on the quarterback. But pressure on the quarterback with contact, that's how you end up winning it.
So here we go on fourth down. Palmer. And it is incomplete. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game. And the Packers are going to get the football back in excellent field position. And they'll start this drive with very good field position. The first carry now. This is Lacy. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down. On second down, here's Rodgers. He finds Randall Cobb with a completion. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
Slam route's effective no matter who's running the route and catching the ball. But when you have a receiver of that stature, you have to be a little bit more precise throwing it. You don't have the same catch radius with the bigger targets.
An extra DB added here for the Cards on third.
Blitzer play coverage.
And a cut. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Eddie Lacy scampering home from 19 yards out. And the Packers have taken the early lead. And it's good to make it 7-0 Packers. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. J.J. Nelson now to return. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Here's the Arizona offense now as they get set to take over. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave them great field position, turned it to 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down
caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
Regular. Let's go.
Second and 10, it's Palmer again. He's got time. He's going to wind. He's got a man complete. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40.
Strength throwing the football downfield has never been an issue for this big guy. I still remember the first time I met him. He was playing for USC, and when I got introduced to him, I thought I was meeting their starting tight end, not their starting quarterback.
Such a presence, Carson Palmer.
Very much so. He's had it ever since he entered campus there and still has it today.
And he stopped immediately there. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. So now 11 yards to go for this offensive unit. It's second down.
Well, on that play, the expression, don't blink, you might miss something, certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat.
And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen, where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
Ready to go now in the second quarter. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis. It's the Cardinals in possession of the football. They're looking at a second and short yardage to start things out. On second down, Palmer. Caught by Nelson left side. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. They get nine out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
And now the offense operates in the red zone. They come out here in the eye. A first down carry here for Johnson. And strong running there as he's inside the 10 and down to the 8-yard line.
Partner, I know we're supposed to be impartial and not rude, but be honest. Weren't you excited for the opportunity for David Johnson of Arizona to have 100 yards from scrimmage in each and every game this year?
Yeah, NFL record, 15 straight games at the century mark. Disappointingly, though, couldn't get that clean sweep, just 44 yards in the Cardinals finale after he was forced to exit with a knee injury.
But how about the way he broke out in 2016, one of the stars of the future in the NFL?
The 6 yards on the pickup, and it leaves him with a first and goal. So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. More from the desert after this. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. From the 2-yard line now, it's first and goal. On the ground, this is Johnson. No gain there, and it's going to set up second and goal. So stuffed from the 2, now what?
You know me pretty well. What do you think I want here?
Play action?
Definitely. Let him get outside and create. And if he has to run it, he has a little bit more space.
Second and goal as the offense looks to try to punch it in. Now Johnson. And he will get into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. David Johnson taking it in from a yard out. And the Cardinals are just an extra point away from tying this game. So now after the timeout, they'll try for it one more time. Palmer looking to throw. It's complete. And he'll get into the end zone as the 2-point conversion is successful. Now Catanzaro after the touchdown to kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. And as the Packers get set to come back out on offense, and Charles, I want to ask you a question. You can take it offensively or defensively for Green Bay as they look to next year. Where do they need to focus, draft and otherwise?
I think I'll start on the offensive side of the ball, and I think running back is going to be a position they have to address. No matter what they decide to do with Eddie Lacy, decide what they're going to do with Ty Montgomery, and get more running backs into the mix. I think offensive line, you're always wanting to fortify that position. But flip it over to the defensive side, Who's going to be the pass rusher besides Clay Matthews? Is Nick Perry still coming on? Do they have to draft someone else to help supplement Julius Peppers? In the secondary, they need corners that can cover. That's a big spot for them.
Rodgers to throw on second down. Escaping the pressure right. And complete right side to Cook. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. A little risky there when you roll out of that pocket right like he did. You complete the pass, but you don't get anything out of it.
But how many times have we seen when a quarterback exits out of the pocket? Doesn't matter if they go left or right. The defense loses its leverage, right? There's a little chaos.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Rodgers now on first down. He completes it to Jordy Nelson. One thing's for sure, with Jordy Nelson, you can't fault his toughness. And we saw that on display in the NFC Championship game with that rib injury he played through.
To be honest with you, I didn't think he was going to play in the game. When I hear two cracked ribs, I just don't see that as a recipe for a guy being able to play wide receiver in a championship game. And he came back in about 2 weeks' time. You're exactly right. Excellent toughness, incredible toughness. And how about the production during the game? He was a factor, especially early.
Yeah, scored a touchdown, 67 yards as well. So the D gets the sack on first, and now it brings up second down. They stay on the ground. This time it's Lacy. And a solid run down inside the 30. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime.
And they insert their dime package. Six DBs here on third and six.
Expecting pass all the way. And he finds Cook. A gain of eight and a first down. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. And Crosby missed it. No good. Wide to the left for Crosby. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And that'll take the field. They're close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up. And we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Partner, you know I love to point out when teams break tendency and do something a little bit different from the norm. But when you run the ball in the first play of the drive, that's not a tendency breaker at all. That's just trying to establish yourself as you move forward.
And this is Cook with a grab. That catch good for five. It's third down.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down. Third and five, so they bring in an extra defensive back.
Expecting pass. To throw is right. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Tony Jefferson. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36. He had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
This time, Palmer will throw. he throws there, incomplete. That one was intended for John Brown, and it's third down. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
He's going to air one out, and he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays, and you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
This is caught inside the 15. Give him 28 yards on that one, and they're able to move the chains as they convert on fourth and long. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. They'll come up now in the Wildcat package. The Wildcat to Johnson. And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. David Johnson, his second touchdown of the night. And the Cardinals will extend their lead. Not only touchdown number 2 for him, but a big run to boot. However, still trailing.
Still trailing, but not because of his efforts. Boy, he's playing really well, and I love his long speed there, right? Able to get out there and burst all the way to the end zone, and smart enough to keep the ball in his hands and get into the end zone for the touchdown. In 2016, on all levels of football, we're seeing guys drop it before the goal line. What's the rule, Brandon? Run into the goal post.
That's right.
Before you drop the ball. There you go.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Now a play fake here on first down. And almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down. Okay, partner, you ready for Brandon's off-the-wall stat question of the week here?
Well, is that any different than any other time we talk?
No, it's not. But Chris Hogan,
yes,
and Julio Jones actually had the exact same numbers in the conference title games. 9 catches, 180 yards, 2 touchdowns. Who did it better?
Wow, that's a great question. Listen. The easy trite answer is they both did it so exceptionally well, you just called a tie.
But I'm not breaking the tie.
Julio Jones did it better. That short slant where he ended up running over 2 or 3 people and taking it to the end zone, that was the clincher right there. Julio Jones did it a little bit better than Chris Hogan.
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Putting pressure on the guy throwing the football is always good. But when you can couple that with contact on him that leads to an incompletion, as we just saw there, that's winning football.
And they're going to at least line up to go for it here on fourth down. They do go for it. It's Rodgers. It's caught. Nelson. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. On first down, Rodgers eluding the pressure right. And incomplete on the deep ball. Devontae Adams, the intended receiver. And now it's second down. Well, they haven't had a whole lot of success in the passing game here. Now, in the second half, he's thinking, I guess maybe just take a shot deep.
I think you're right. Almost looking for a bailout, isn't he? Can my receiver go up and make a big play for me? Can I create a penalty downfield, maybe pick up an interference call and get that yardage downfield? Anything. thing trying to get going again, but you're right, he definitely took a shot.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Rodgers again now. And Davis has it over the middle. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. Welcome back to the desert. We're in Glendale. It's the Packers who have the football, but in need of points as we begin quarter number four. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Rodgers with a keeper. Call it a three-yard gain. And on fourth down, they're able to convert and move the sticks.
Fourth and one. I don't think Wild Horses could have dragged that quarterback off the field. He was motioning to go for it from the start. And sure enough, it's the ground game that gets him the first down.
Now this time, Rodgers will throw. He gets it over the middle to Cobb. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. And now they're in the hurry up.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays. And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense.
This will be caught by Nelson for a Packer touchdown. Jordy Nelson, a 14-yard touchdown. And the Packers are back within a score. And it's good. It cuts it to two. 16-14 our score. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. So out now come the Cardinals. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
It'll be a gain of four, and that'll bring up second down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. They come out here in the eye. They stay on the ground on first with Johnson. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. And now a timeout coming from the defensive side for the Packers. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. They come out with one back and three tight ends. Al Palmer. Fitzgerald's got it right side. They give it. And now the Packers going to take another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play.
That was a nicely run slant route. And what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route. And then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from.
And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. It'll be their third and final timeout. So as they talk things over, we'll step aside. Second down following the run.
Three down.
They go throw to Johnson again. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. So nothing there, but maybe you blame that on the blocking.
Yeah, at some point, you've got to win at the point of attack. And on that play, that was all the defense. They made it happen.
Here we go. Wide, 18.
On third down, Johnson. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. It's a loss of a full 3 yards, and it brings up fourth down. And they're going to take it all the way down and just take the delay.
Good job. Too easy.
Here comes the Cardinals punter now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. This is taken at the 15. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And possession will change here with very little time remaining in this contest. Now the Packers get set to go. So you're right there, but obviously the clock is not your friend. How do you handle this situation?
You're thinking two plays. One, to get yourself in position for the second one. Whether you're able to get into field goal range, or you have to try another deep pass, another Hail Mary. But you're trying to get the first one to a receiver, get out of bounds, and give yourself a chance to set things up for an easier shot at it.
We'll see if they can do it. Might be easier said than done. He'll look to throw. And this will be incomplete. 1 second left to go.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it, no one got it. Now a desperation throw deep downfield, and it's incomplete. Rodgers has done it before, but he won't get the connection here, and the ball game is over.